Welcome to a recap of 13th chapter National Liberation Movement in the Colonies. In this chapter, we have studied about Chinese Revolution, how people were colonized by Britain and how they made a great struggle in order to get independence from the Britain. Let us go back to the its past history. Europeans have tried their level best to colonize different countries of the world. In that process, they wanted to occupy even China. The main exotic raw material which was found in China was tea and silk. For this, they wanted to colonize China. But Chinese government make a strict rule and did not allow any of the Europeans. Britain made a good groundwork and finally came to know that Chinese are very weak to the opium. So they have cultivated opium in India and secretly smuggled into the Chinese territory. They started manipulating or bribing the custom authority of China and finally illegally smuggled opium into China. Finally, this led to opium war between China and Britain. So in this way, Britain could occupy China. So in those days, it was ruled by Manchu dynasty. And Manchu, they couldn't defend themselves or prove themselves strong. Colonial pressure and power, emperors were forced to collect low import taxes, exemption or protection from the Chinese law, maintaining armed forces. So due to this, the common people and the administrators tried to reform the system, started revolting against the Western power. Finally, Manchu dynasty was overthrown in 1911 and Republic government was formed in China under the leadership of Sun Yat-sen, where we see Sun Yat-sen was considered to be as the father of modern China. He took up three principles, San Min Chui, brought lot of reformations. And after Sun Yat-sen, we come across Chiang Kai-shek, who has taken up the leadership of China. People were not satisfied by Chiang Kai-shek, and in order to get back the Chinese territories from Japan, which was occupied, and they started protesting against the Treaty of Versailles, according to which it was told that the countries who got defeated in the First World War have to surrender the territories of the colonies back to them. But this was not done. And that too, China, being an ally, couldn't get back its territory from Japan. So they started a protest movement, and that protest movement is called as May 4th Move, and advocated many changes like simple script, abolition of subordinate position to the women, abolition of food binding, equality in marriage, economic development to end poverty. So in that way, they wanted to bring lot of reform in China. In the process of reformation, we come across two parties, that is Chinese Communist Party and the KMT Party. KMT Party, already I told you about the Sun Yat-sen, which was started by him. Later on, it was continued by Chiang Kai-shek. But Chiang Kai-shek, being a conservative person, couldn't be that successful. In the next part of this chapter, we came across the rise of Communist Party of China. And in this process, we have seen about Japanese invasion into China 1937, where the Chinese people have struggled and got exhausted due to the continuous wars made by Japan, Britain. And during this process, that is 1945 to 49, the prices rose by 30% per month. This destroyed the life of the common people. Common people, or the rural people of China, had to face two crises, ecological and the social crisis. Apart from that, many of the people in China, the peasants, the artisans, the handicrafts, their condition started to deteriorate. Their situation became very worst. They sold their land and paid the tax. they fell into debt traps. The people who were called as the landowner became the land tiller finally. So Chinese Communist Party actually came into formation in the year 1921, just after Russian Revolution. Major CCP leader was Mao Zedong. He made a social base in the rural area and he started to solve the peasantry problem, and he motivated the peasants to fight against abolition of landlordism. For this, he built the peasantry armies, peasantry corporations, societies, so forth and so on. By this, he became very famous. The MT party couldn't bear this name and fame of Chinese Communist Party and made an attack on CCP, for which CCP had to move away from the mainland to Jiangxi Mountain. They have stayed there for 6 years. So Mao carried out his peasantry council, collected the land from the landlords, the rich elite in the Chinese territory, and distributed to the landless poor. Apart from that, Mao has started organizing women association, new marriage laws, and special status was given even to the women in the society. That rose the power, the name, fame of Mao in the society, which KMT couldn't bear and made an attack on CCP party once again, where Chinese Communist Party was forced to find another base, extend Yan'an as a new base, and carried out their first twin policy, land reform and nationalism. So this made him more and more successful and popular. During this process, that is 1937 to 1945, Japan occupied much of China. Japan imposed cruel laws over China and destroyed socially, economically. So during this process, KMT and CCP, both of them decided to get united and to defeat Japan, which was the only solution. So that is in the year 1945, when Japan got defeated by America in Second World War, Japan became weak in its main territory. KMT and CCP, both of them found this is the best chance to defeat Japan, and finally defeated and brought the entire China under Chinese government control. Eventually, CCP was successful in establishing its rule over mainland China, while KMT was forced to set up in island of Taiwan. The next topic we have studied is establishing the new democracy in 1949 to 1954. Based on new democratic principles, people started opposing two things, landlordism and imperialism. They want to bring a change in China. After coming to power, CCP started large-scale land reform measures. First thing which was done under the CCP government was, they have identified the rural people, landless laborers, and then distributed the land to the actual needy person. Country level reform committees played a leading role. It was successful mainly because leaders were selected from the local people, local leaders. They started mobilizing the rural people, rural masses, and conducted meetings, and they started to share their problems before the courts. So courts have taken up many trials against the landlords who have troubled the peasants. So large number of landlords were proved guilty, were executed in these trials. Finally, we can see that middle class and the poor people became the rich elite in the society, and old elite lost their economic status, property and power. New elite took birth from poor and the middle class peasants. So new elite, they were brought into political work by the CCP. Finally, in order to bring lot of reformation, the CCP set up adult peasantry schools to spread literacy and political knowledge. Primary schools, two were started for young and the adult in the village. So most of the scholars says that the main success of Chinese Republic government is due to land reform and universal education. CCP built a powerful social base for future development of China.